Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to use customizable tables in Stata 17 to create a table from multiple Stata commands. I'm going to be using the NHANES2L dataset, and you can open this by typing webuse NHANES2L. So I'm going to begin by clicking Statistics, and then Summaries, Tables, and Tests, and then I'll select Tables of Frequency, Summaries, and Command Results. And this will open the table dialog box. So in the main tab, I'm going to begin by clicking columns, the arrow next to columns, and I'm going to scroll down near the bottom and select Command Option Index. Then I'm going to click the Commands tab and I'm going to click Create. So here I can type a Stata command. So I'm going to type regress BP systol as my dependent variable. And then I'm going to type c.age for age as a continuous variable, and then hashtag i.sex. And so I'm using factor variable notation to tell Stata that age is continuous, sex is categorical, and I'm using the double hashtag to fit a model that includes the main effective age, the main effective sex, as well as the interaction of the two. So that's my command, and I'm going to click accept and then click submit. And now I can see, if I move the table over here, the dialog box, I can see a rough table that includes the results of this model. Now what I'm going to do is add a couple more commands. So I can come back to the Commands tab in the dialog box and click Create again. So let's type regress BP systol, and let's fit a model that just includes age and sex, but without the interaction term. Okay, so then I can click Accept, and when I click Submit, now it's running both of these. The table is running off the side of the results window here, but we'll fix that momentarily. So let's add a third command. I'm going to come back to the dialog and click Create again, and again type regress, BP systol, and again I'm going to include age and sex, and let's also include a third variable, health status. I think it's HLTHSTAT, health stat. We'll see if that works in a moment. So if I click submit, that was the right variable name. So now I have three columns or three commands, and I can see the results in this table, or at least I can see the left-hand side of it. It's running off the results window. So that's the basic table. Now I'd like to customize it. So I'm going to come back to the main tab and click the customize button here in the bottom right. And this will allow me to customize it however I like. This opens the tables builder. And here in the preview window, I can see all three models. I have three columns, one for each of the models that I fit, as well as a list of the coefficients down the left side. Now, a list of the variables down the left side. So the first thing I might want to do is clean up the factor variables. I have the base levels for each of the factor variables, such as sex equals male. Notice the coefficients are all zero. For the interaction between sex equals male and age, those are all zero. So I can clean that up by going to Show Hide Coefficient Styles. And then in the Collect Style Item dialog box, it's already selected for me. It says Show Base Levels for Factor Variables and Interactions. And I'm going to select off. It's already selected for me. So when I click OK, notice that those base levels have been removed from my table. The next thing I want to do is I want to change the labels of the columns here. So I'm going to come over to Edit Level Labels, click that button, and this will open the Collect Label Levels dialog box. And so I want to adjust the column names. Whoops, not the column names, sorry. I want the commands. And I have three commands, and so I'm going to select each one of them just so I can see what they are. And so the current labels, are the actual commands themselves. And so I'm going to change these. I'm going to call this model 1. And the second one, I'm just going to call it model 2. Can't type today. Then the last model is model 3. And when I click OK, now I've relabeled those columns, and that's a little bit easier to read. So the next thing I'd like to do is clean up these decimals. And so I'm going to click on Cell Appearance Styles. And then I'm going to select some tags here. I'm going to select tag 1, 2, and 3. And then for the dimensions, I want to change the dimension command. And I want to do this for three, the same dimension, all three commands. And I want to change level one, or model one, and model two, and model three. And so I want to change the format of the numbers. I want to change them to fixed numeric with three decimal places of accuracy. So I'm going to do that and click submit. And now I can see that they're all reported with three digits to the right of the decimal. Okay. Another thing that I might want to do, well, actually, let's click OK and then reopen this so we can start from scratch. I might also want to remove this vertical line here on the right-hand side. So that's a vertical line on the right side of this leftmost column. So I can click on borders. And then what I want to do is check the box next to separate style for each side. And what I want to do is remove that right border. And so I'm going to select nil for the pattern and click submit. And now I can see that I've removed that vertical line from the right side of that column. Another thing I might want to do to the entire table is I might want to change the font. So here I'm going to type Arial for the font and click submit. And now I've changed the font to Arial. And I might also want to add a bit of space. So I could click the margins tab here. And I want to click separate style for each side. And I'm going to add a margin of 5 to the top width, 15 to the right, 5 to the bottom, and 15 to the left. And I only know this because I've experimented with it. And so what that does is add a little bit of space here in between the numbers and the columns, the rows and columns. There are other things that I can do. I can adjust the display of the row labels and things like that, but we'll come back and do that in another video. So when I'm finished and I like the way my table looks, I can come over here and click on Export and export my table to a variety of formats, either Word documents, a Word document, HTML file, PDF, Microsoft Excel, LaTeX, SMICL, text files, or Markdown. So then I can put this table in one of those documents. So that's how you can use customizable tables in Stata 17 to create a table from multiple Stata commands. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.